Dear students, our today's topic is mechanisms of sex determination, and in this tutorial we will study about the mechanism of sex segregation, sex determination in different species, in different organisms, and we will come to know the various mechanisms that how the sex segregation takes place and what are the factors for sex determination in different species. As we know that some members of a species are male and others are female, that a species is made up of some total of organisms of male and female, and a population is a group of organisms of same species. And if we divide all the organisms of a population or a species, then we will have broadly two groups, that one group is constituted by male and the other group is by female. And the mechanism by which sex is established is termed sex determination. So sex of an individual is defined based on its phenotype and not on the genotype, because as we know that the human female has the genetic or genotype XX. So this XX should develop into a female, but it is also noted that this XX genotype is also associated with the development of male characters, and that will be discussed after some time. So based on the location of reproductive organs, the organisms, and here we are taking the examples of plants. The organisms or the plants are classified into three categories. Some are hermaphrodites or bisexual. It means when both the sexual organs, that is sex organs of male and female, are present in same flower or on same organism, that organism or that plant is called hermaphrodite. As we can see here that this is a plant, and here this is a flower, and this is another flower located on same plant, and both the flowers are bisexual, as represented by their symbols, that this is a male flower and this is a female flower. So these type of plants or organisms having both the sexes, both the sex together located on same organism or on same plant, are called hermaphrodite. And another category is the monoecious, and this term is generally used in case of plants, that when both the sex organs are separated but present on the same plant. As we can see here that this is a monoecious plant. Here the male flower and female flower are segregated. It means two different type of flowers are present, both male and female, but located on same plant. So this is a monoecious plant. But in case of animals, the hermaphrodite and monoecious is the same condition. And the third category of organism is dioecious, that when both the sex organs are present on separate plants or separate individuals, separate organisms. As we know that in human beings there are two different sex, male and female. So the human being is an example of dioecious organism. And as we can see in this example, this figure shows that these two plants are here, example of dioecious plant, that one plant has the female flowers only located and the other plant has only the male flowers. So in among dioecious species, sex may be determined by three factors, three different factors. First is the chromosomal method or chromosomal cause of sex segregation. Second one is the genic, that is based on the genes. And third one is the environmental cause of sex segregation. So first we will take the chromosomal sex determining system, that is the sex segregation takes place or based on the different type of chromosomes on present in separate a male and female, separate individuals. So first case is the XXXO sex determination. Here the example is grasshoppers, and in this case the females are having two X chromosome as represented by here. The females are having two X chromosome, whereas the males are having only one X chromosome. So the females are represented with XX and males are represented with XO. Here the O represents the absence of any chromosome. O is not any chromosome, but it represents that there is no chromosome together with X chromosome. So O indicates the absence of a chromosome. So here the females are homogametic because all the gametes will have the X chromosome, whereas in male the two type of gametes will be produced. In some gametes, or 50% of gametes will have X chromosome, whereas the other 50% will have no gamete at all. The second method of chromosomal sex determination is the XXXY sex determination, and it is observed in a number of organisms including plants, insects, reptiles, and the famous example is the human beings. And here the females are having two same chromosome, that is represented by XX, and the males are represented with XY. So females are homogametic. It means all the gametes of females will have the same chromosome, that is X, whereas in the male two type of gametes will be produced. Some will be having X chromosome and others will be having Y chromosome. So the males are heterogametic. And the in duck-billed platypus, an organism Ornithorhynchus anatinus, the females have 10 X chromosome and the males have 5 X and 5 Y chromosomes. And in human beings, the X and Y chromosomes participate in homologous pairing, as we know that the homologous pairing takes place at the time of meiosis, that is the meiotic division or the gamete formation. And here at that time the homologous chromosome pairing takes place and there is exchange of genetic material between homologous chromosomes. So the sex chromosomes in human beings is X and Y, and both the chromosomes assemble together and form at the time of meiosis. And as the X chromosome is quite different to Y chromosome, but certain regions of X and Y chromosomes shows homology, and that's why the homologous pairing takes place between X and Y chromosomes. So here the process of sex determination in human beings, as we know that in human beings the X and Y chromosomes are known as the sex chromosomes, and the homologous pairing takes place between X and Y chromosomes. And here the homology between X and Y chromosome is due to the same gene or similar genes present at the apical portion of both the X and Y chromosome. This is Y chromosome, quite smaller as compared to the X chromosome, and this red lining at the apices or at the terminal portion of both the X and Y chromosome shows the pseudo autosomal region. So the smaller arm or the short arm of both chromosome shows the homology, that is called pseudo autosomal region, primary pseudo autosomal, and the long arm of both the X and Y chromosome shows another homology, and that is called secondary pseudo autosomal region. And here that as we can see in this example, that this is a normal X and this is a normal Y chromosome, and this genotype is represented by a normal male. But sometimes it is possible that two X chromosome, this genotype is associated with female, but here if a part of Y chromosome, this is a part of a Y chromosome located on this X chromosome, this part, that is the SRY, that is sex region, sex determining region present on this X chromosome. So this genotype develops into a male. So this is called XX male. And similarly, if the Y chromosome is missing with that SRY gene, so this genotype XY will develop into a female. So The Y chromosome bears a region SRY, that is sex determining region, located just outside the pseudo autosomal region in the short arm of the Y chromosome, and this SRY gene produces a protein or a factor that is called testis determining factor that is responsible for the development of testis. And if the SRY gene is absent, there is no production of TDF, and as a result of there is the production of female gamete or female phenotype. The third and last category of the chromosomal sex determining mechanism is represented by ZZ and ZW, and it is represented by birds, snakes, butterflies, and some amphibians and some fish. But here that it is here in this case the females are heterogametic. It means the females will produce two types of gametes, whereas the males are homogametic, as contrast to the human beings we have just studied. So to not get confused with XX and XY system of sex determination, that's why here the ZZ and ZW system or notations or the symbols were used. And here another thing is to keep in mind that the chromosomes does not look like Z and W. Similarly, X and Y, it is not the shape of the chromosome as these notations or these symbols are being used. And the second mechanism of sex determination is the genic, that is based on genes. So here, in some plants, fungi, and protozoans, sex is genetically determined. But there are no obvious differences in the chromosomes of males and females. So here the chromosomes looks similar both in males and females. So it is not possible, or it becomes difficult to differentiate between the chromosomes of male and female. So in this case, it is known as genic sex determination, that is the genes present on these chromosomes and how these genes express themselves to produce two different type of sex. And the only difference between genic and chromosomal sex determination is that in chromosomal sex determination, there is two different type of chromosomes in male and female, whereas in genic sex determination, all the chromosomes of both male and female are same. So here the genes plays certain definite role in the segregation of sex. The third category of sex determination is the environmental sex determination, and here the environmental factors are responsible for the segregation of sex. And as we can see the examples of marine mollusk, here the example, the organism or the animal is shown here, and this is known as slipper limpet. And here in this case that the first larva of this animal settle on an unoccupied ground, and then it secretes certain chemicals and attracts another larva on the top of it, and the lowermost larva develops into a female, and the larva that comes over it develops into a male. But after some time, this second larva that was used as a male initially becomes a female after some time and attracts another larva over it, and this process of first becoming male and then converting into female, this process goes on for all the larva, stacking one over the other, and the ultimate, the topmost larva will develop into male. And here this is the examples of the environmental, that at which position these larvae are settled is and that their position will determine that they will develop into male or female. The another mechanism or example of environmental sex determination is in turtles and in crocodiles. And here if the eggs after fertilization are incubated at low temperature, that is below 28 degrees Celsius, then all the turtle eggs will develop into male. But when the fertilized eggs are incubated above the temperature of 31 degrees Celsius, all the eggs develop into female. Now the special case of sex determination in fruit fly and Drosophila melanogaster, here the diploid number is 8, so the haploid number, that is n, is equal to 4, and in this organism the Y chromosome does not have to play any role in sex determination. However, it is the ratio of X chromosome with the haploid set of autosomes, and as we can understand that if the 2n is 8 and in Drosophila the sex chromosomes are just like humans, XX in females and XY in males, but the Y chromosome, unlike the human males, the Y chromosome of Drosophila does not play any role in sex determination. It is the ratio of X chromosome with the haploid set of autosome that is responsible for sex segregation in Drosophila. And when the ratio of X chromosome with the haploid set of autosome is equal to 1, then it produces female. When the ratio X ratio A is equal to 0.5, it produces a male. And when the ratio is less than 0.5, male phenotype is produced, called metamales. And when the ratio is more than is between 1 to 0.5, then it produces an intersex fly with a mixture of male and female characteristics. And when the ratio is greater than 1, a female phenotype is produced, that's called a metafemale. So here in this case, it is the ratio of X with the haploid set of autosomes. And as we know that if two chromosomes XX and XY out of the 8 chromosomes are the sex chromosome, then remaining 6 chromosomes is the autosomes, and the half of the 6, that is 3 chromosome, is one set of haploid autosome. So here we can see clearly about the Drosophila, that how the sex segregation takes place in Drosophila. So if the two X chromosomes having two set of autosomes, it means 2 divided by 2, that comes to 1, and it develops into female. Similarly, if the genotype is XY and there are two sets of haploid autosomes, so it comes 1 upon 2, and that is 0.5, and it develops into male. Similarly, if there is only one X chromosome and two sets of haploid autosomes, then it comes to X upon A, that is 1 upon 2, and it is further 0.5, and it will also develop into male. So here the XY and XO, it is both are the male. So here the Y has nothing to do with the development of sex, and however, it is the ratio of X with A. And similarly here, two X chromosomes and two sets of haploid autosomes, so 2 divided by 2 comes to 1, and it develops into female. Similarly, 3X and 2 haploid autosomes pair, so 3 by 2 is 1.5, so here it develops into metafemale. Similarly here, we can see the 3X chromosome with 2 pair of haploid autosomes, and here the 3 upon 2, again 1.5, and it develops into metafemale. And here 2 X chromosome but 3 pair of autosomes, so it comes to 2 by 3, that is 0.67, and it comes to, and it develops into intersex. And when X, the number of X chromosome divided by total number of haploid autosomes, here and here, this is the 3 set, so 1 upon 3 is equal to 0.33, and it develops into a metamale. And when the 4 X chromosome divided by 3 autosome pairs, it is known as, it is 4 by 3, and it comes to 1.3, and it develops into metafemale. So here A is 1A represent one haploid set of autosomes, 2A represents two haploid set of autosomes, and 3A is the 3 haploid set of autosomes.